morning, guys. Welcome to another Sunday service. Before we begin with our Bible lesson, let's pray. Father God, thank you so much for today that we can worship you again. Lord, we lift up this time so that you can open our eyes and our ears. So when we listen to your word, that we may understand it and that it will touch our hearts. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Okay, so today's Bible lesson is called Mission Possible. And before we continue, let's read our theme Bible passage together. Ready, set, go. We know that we all possess knowledge, but knowledge puffs up while love builds up. Those who think they know something do not yet know as they ought to know. But whoever loves God is known by God. 1 Corinthians chapter 8. Verses 1, 2, 3. And now, we are ready for our round 10 Bible trivia. So today's questions are related to unlikely heroes that we've been watching since we were very young. So, first question is, so here are some clues. So he was always rich. All of a sudden, he loses his parents, and he decides to fight for justice at night. And this is Batman. Question number two. This hero always wanted to be a hero. He worked as a noodle cook with his father, and his color is actually black and white. And he's not a human. And this is Po from Kung Fu Panda. He becomes a dragon warrior in the movie, right? And question number three. This hero was a regular high school student, and one day he gets bitten by an insect, and he lives with his aunt. And you guessed it, it's Spider-Man. So in our Bible lesson today, the character that we're going to kind of talk about, actually you guys are very, very familiar with him. He's a very unlikely hero in our Bible story. He actually hated Jesus, he hated Christians, and he hated the church. And so he went around imprisoning the Christians. He actually killed some of them too. But one day he has this amazing encounter with Jesus, and that's how he becomes a hero in the Bible. So we're going to read about him in Acts chapter 9, verses 1 through 19. And so let's all read it together. Ready, set, go. Meanwhile, Saul was still breathing out murderous threats against the Lord's disciples. He went to the high priest and asked him for letters to the synagogues in Damascus so that if he found any there who belonged to the way, whether men or women, he might take them as prisoners to Jerusalem. As he neared Damascus on his journey, suddenly a light from heaven flashed around him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice say to him, "Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me?" "Who are you, Lord?" Saul asked. "I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting," he replied. "Now, get up and go into the city, and you will be told what you must do." The men traveling with Saul stood there speechless. They heard the sound but did not see anyone. Saul got up from the ground, but when he opened his eyes, he could see nothing. So they led him by the hand into Damascus. For 3 days he was blind and did not eat or drink anything. In Damascus, there was a disciple named Ananias. The Lord called to him in a vision. "Ananias." "Yes, Lord," he answered. The Lord told him, "Go to the house of Judas on Straight Street and ask for a man from Tarsus named Saul, for he is praying. In a vision, he has seen a man named Ananias come and place his hands on him to restore his sight." "Lord," Ananias answered, "I have heard many reports about this man and all the harm he has done to our holy people in Jerusalem. and he has come here with authority from the chief priests to arrest all who call on your name. But the Lord said to Ananias, go, this man is my chosen instrument to proclaim my name to the Gentiles and their kings and to the people of Israel. I will show him how much he must suffer for my name. Then Ananias went to the house and entered it. Placing his hands on Saul, he said, Brother Saul, the Lord Jesus, who appeared to you on the road as you were coming here, has sent me so that you may see again and be filled with the Holy Spirit. Immediately, something like scales fell from Saul's eyes, and he could see again. He got up and was baptized, and after taking some food, he regained his strength. Now, we are going to watch together a short clip of that explains this passage in a very good way. So let's watch it together.
Long ago, there was a man named Saul who did everything in his power to stop people from following Jesus. He was sure that the followers of Jesus were the enemies of God. He put many of them in prison, and some of them were even killed. Sometime later, Saul and his companions were headed for the city of Damascus, where they planned to arrest the followers of Jesus. Suddenly, a bright light flashed around Saul. He fell to the ground in fear and heard a voice ask him, Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me? Saul responded, Who are you, Lord? The voice answered, I am Jesus whom you are persecuting. Jesus told him to get up and go into the city where he would be told what he should do. So Saul got up, but he couldn't see. He was blind. His companions had to lead him by the hand into Damascus to a disciple named Ananias. Jesus told Ananias that he should lay hands on Saul, but Ananias was afraid. He had heard of all the things that Saul had been doing to the followers of Jesus. Jesus assured him that Saul had changed and that God had important work for Saul to do. Ananias obeyed Jesus. He found Saul and laid his hands on him. Then Saul was filled with the Holy Spirit, and something like scales fell from his eyes. Now he could see once again. Then Ananias baptized Saul. Saul was transformed, and his new name was now Paul.
As we read through Paul's story, it's really amazing because it really proves to us that anyone can be a hero of the faith. He was Saul, someone, again, who hated all the Christians, who didn't like the church, so that he went around and destroyed all the churches. And he actually would have been considered a villain in the story of the Bible, right? But he, after him seeing Jesus on his way to Damascus, he changes 180%. He becomes a follower of Jesus Christ, and his name even changes to Paul. So after he became Paul, he went around to different cities and countries so that he could preach the good news of Jesus. Paul performed miracles in Jesus' name. When he was chained up in prison, God released him. Paul survived shipwrecks and even spoke to before Caesar, the emperor and ruler of the Roman Empire. And even though Paul must have been really scared, he knew that Jesus was protecting him. And so that's why he had the courage and strength to go to others and speak about Jesus. And what we can also learn from him is that you and I, you especially, even though you may be young, it doesn't matter because you can make a difference in this world. And just as Paul, someone who was a villain, God turned him around and he became a Bible hero, you can also become a hero in this world. Because God has an amazing calling for you, and God really desires that you also share the good news of Jesus to others. And where can we start? We can start with the people that are closest to us, That could be our friends from school, our neighborhood, even our family members that don't know Jesus very well yet. And so, you know what? We do need a lot of courage and strength from God in order to share, because it could be scary sometimes. So a place that we can start is that through prayer. We can pray to God, God, give us strength, give us courage so that we can speak about you to others. And so hopefully this message encourages you that you are very special and God has great plans for you and you can make a difference in this world. And that's it for today's message. Let's pray and close today's service. Father God, thank you so much for your message. We lift up this time so that you can truly use us, Father, for your kingdom work. Lord, give us strength and courage so that we can share Jesus with our friends, our families, and our neighbors, that they may also get to know you, that they may also experience true joy in you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.